Hello guys, today I'll be recommending a list of amazing historical action movies you really need to check out. From Master Swordsman, amazing archers, monsters, amazing military strategies and a lot more. I'll be recommending my top 10 action historical Korean movies. Now starting off with my favorite on the list, The Admiral, Roaring Currents. The movie was a box office hit and one of the most watched Korean movies out there. It stars the likes of Cho Min-sik, Ryu Seul-young and Park Bo-gum. The movie was based on the true life story of one of the most respected generals in Korean history. During a Japanese invasion in the 16th century, a bold general, despite his failing health, was forced to defend his nation against an army, despite being outnumbered in every way possible. With only 13 ships under his command, he fought against over 300 warships. The movie was literally a masterpiece and you're really going to enjoy it. And now, coming at number 2, War of Arrows. War of Arrows aired back in 2011 and was directed by Kim Han-min, who also directed The Admiral. The movie stars the likes of Park Hae-hyun, Ryu Seul-young and Moon Chae-won. When their family were accused of treason, Nam-hyun was entrusted with his younger sister by his dad to protect her. Now, he would grow up to be the best archer in Korea. Now, during the Manchu invasion, his sister was taken hostage, dragged by the brutal soldiers on her wedding day. With nothing but a bow and arrow, he goes up against the Qing dynasty. This is a movie about what a desperate brother will do to save his little sister. I really like well-made action movies and this one really did a great job with the action scenes and the story was also interesting. Number 3, The Great War. The Great War aired in 2018 and is based on a true life story. This movie is amazingly action-packed with real thrilling military strategies you will enjoy. It was directed by Kim Kwan-sik and stars the likes of Jo In-sung, Kim So-woon, Nam Joo-hyuk and Park Sung-won. The movie was set during the invasion of Goguryeo, an ancient kingdom of Korea by the emperor of the Tang dynasty. The Anxi fortress was protected and defended by General Yang, who was abandoned by his country and is now outnumbered by thousands of the Tang army. The brave and smart general gathers his men and women to face the Tang dynasty on his own as they fight to the death to defend the fortress. You're gonna love the action scenes. Now coming at number 4 is the 2018 movie Monstro, an amazing action movie revolving around the hunting and killing of a very dangerous monster. It has the likes of Kim Yong-min, Lee Hee-ri, Choi Woo-shik and Kim In-kwon. Now in the time of a deadly outbreak of a plague and the rumors of a terrifying monster in the mountains, this leads the king to call upon his most trusted general from exile to investigate and hunt down this beast. The general and his daughter will set out to the mountain to track down this beast. Trust me, you're going to love this movie. It really had good action scenes and the CGI of the beast was really good. Now coming at number 5, Rampant. Now Rampant is a zombie action movie that aired in 2018. It was directed by Kim Sung-woo, who also directed the box office hit Confidential Assignment. The movie stars the likes of Hyun Bin, Jang Dong-gun, Jo Woo-jin and Lee Seo-bin. The story revolves around Prince Lee Chun, who came back to Joseon after being taken hostage by the Wang dynasty. He's also a very good swordsman. After the news of his brother, the crown prince's death, he is forced to save and protect his brother's pregnant wife in a time when the land was plagued by zombies. They will fight to survive and also to save the nation, which was already at the verge of being destroyed. And coming at number 6, Kundo, Age of Rampant. Released in 2014, the movie was directed by Yoon Jong-bin, who also directed Nameless Gangster. The movie stars the likes of Han Jung-woo, Gang Dong-won, and Man Do-suk. In a cruel time when Joseon is plagued by numerous natural disasters, poverty, hunger and death, with the rich nobles exploiting and persecuting the poor, a righteous group of thieves rose up, stealing from the rich and sharing it to the poor. I think the movie revolves more around the villain, Jo-in, an illegitimate son of a wealthy nobleman, but his mom was a concubine. He struggles from his childhood to get recognition from his father. He possesses amazing outsword skills, even considered the best in the nation, but he plunders the poor and kills anyone he wills. Now, a poor butcher, Domochi's family were killed by Jo-in. Clouded by vengeance, he joins the group of righteous thieves in order to exact revenge. And coming at number 7, The Swordsman. I think this movie probably has the best action scenes on this list. It stars the likes of Jang Hyuk, Kim Yong-soo and Joe Taslim. The story revolves around Tae-yu, who is considered the best swordsman of Joseon. But he went into seclusion in the mountains with his daughter after the death of his master, Rebellious King. And he is now losing his eyesight due to an old injury. All hell breaks loose when his only daughter was captured and taken away by a slave trader. He is forced to pick up his sword again in order to save her. The action scenes were absolutely amazing. And coming at number 8, Memories of the Sword. Memories of the Sword is more of a tragic revenge action movie starring Kim Go-eun, Lee Byung-hun and Jun Do-yeon. Now, three close friends and warriors from the Goryeo dynasty pledge to fight for the impoverished people against the king. However, due to Dogye's betrayal, one of them died and Soran, stricken by guilt, flees with his infant daughter, Hong-ye. She trains a little girl for years and later reveals to her the reason for her father's death. Hong-ye falls in utter shock, leaves Soran and plans to get revenge on both her and Dogye, who is now the most powerful man in the country. Number 9. The Pirates. The Pirates is a really funny action comedy that aired in 2014, starring So Ye-jin and Kim Nam-gil. Jang So-jin used to be a soldier but is now a mountain bandit after his betrayal. Wai Ye-woo, played by Son Ye-jin, is a female captain of pirates who is highly skilled and respected by her comrades. On the eve of the founding of the Joseon dynasty, a giant whale swallows the Ming Emperor's seal of state being brought to Joseon by envoys from China, with a big revolt on whoever brings back the royal seal. The group of mountain bandits led by Jang So-jin go out to sea to hunt down the whale, despite having absolutely no experience sailing the sea. But he soon clashes with Ye-woo, the female captain of the pirates, and an interesting adventure unfolds. Now coming at number 10, The Tiger, an old hunter's tale. The movie aired in 2020 and stars the like of Cho Min-sik, Jung Bang-sik, and Kim Sang-ho. Now set toward the end of the Joseon dynasty, when Korea was under Japanese rule, the story revolves around a one-eyed tiger in the mountains. After its mate and two cubs were killed, he is the last remaining tiger in the peninsula, and it became a symbol of pride and courage to the Korean. Now, a Japanese general obsessed with tigers wanted the capture of the last legendary tiger, but many fell to his wrath after they killed his only surviving family. Despite the movie being slow-paced, it was really an amazing written movie. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe for more movie recommendation videos like this.